Psychic Sleuth, let's try this again. For those of you that saw that I had no sound, I really don't know what happened because I didn't change any settings on my computer. So I wanted to definitely get it on my computer because my phone takes 3 hours to upload and I wanted to get this out. So this is going to be validation for Mackenzie and Noah, July 5th, 2019. I can't believe I did that again. Anyways, it was such a good video. I'm so pissed. So this is some crazy validation. If I had known she was still missing and not found, I would have went back over the reading and kept looking for her or do another reading. They led us to think that that was all of her, so I moved on. Which, you know, I don't know if you guys know how I connect. I have to be connected to recognize anything, and I didn't feel like there was any reason to connect back to her. Anyways, basically as to why as to Ted Bundy was mentioned in here, as well as Nancy Beards. Okay, so Ted Bundy, he drove hours to put bodies in the mountains and in the canyons. This is what AJ did. He drove up to Logan, which is about 2 hours and 12 minutes. Could be the reference to the 12, but also Bundy did kill a 12-year-old girl. So kind of weird. That's just kind of the same numbers as my birthday. Just weird connection. Anyways, AJ put Mackenzie between two mountains, and I kept seeing between two mountains. I even drew it. It's in the group. So, also, I mentioned a river, and I mentioned Woodsy. So, there is a river that flows there, the Logan River, and it is Woodsy. So, also, a weird kind of interconnect. The dam and reservoir came in, Lizzie, back when I did her reading, which is also Utah. So, there is one right where she was found, so that's interesting because that's been coming in for a while. I don't know if you guys remember back in Malia, is kind of a dam reservoir type thing. The dam reservoir type thing has been coming in for a bit, so that's kind of interesting, but, the fact that it came in Lizzie, it makes sense because this is still Utah, so, anyways, she was found right across from Mill Hollow. Duh, right? Okay, because Mill came in strong. It also connects to Noah, so if I would have seen that, it would have kind of had my wheels turning, because it's all right there. Hollow's coming in Cheryl, but it kind of reminds you of the beginning of Halloween. Also, by spring, when you think of spring, you can think of flowers. Also, this road leads to Garden City. Logan is where U of U is. Books are usually my symbol for college, university, but as I said, they can have more than one meaning, so I did mention the college and the university. I just didn't know she was trying to tell us to go to Logan. So, by telling us about the U of U, she was saying Logan and to go there. I didn't realize U of U even was in Logan, honestly, because I was looking all, I was being pulled in all different kinds of directions, so, but it was super important. Also, it was pretty close to where she was found, like it's right before you go up the canyon. He used to live in Logan, so it makes sense he would go back to a familiar spot. It also looks like it has a watchtower, so that came in. You do pass some things, greenleaf, things like greenleaf landscaping. Also brings up the name Perry, which Nancy's middle name is Perry, a name that I've been drawn to and seen everywhere for 3 months now. Hiram, you pass, that's H-Y, and then Providence, you pass, that's the P. So Mill is huge interconnect in this case, and so is fire. I'll kind of explain. So from what I hear, her leg was severed, which I also mentioned in the reading as I saw it on ice when I was showing all that blood and crap. I don't care to recall seeing it. Also, he did burn some of her, so that's a reference to cremation or incineration because her tissue was found. Also, now if you go to Little Noah, he was found in what a boy would call a factory. Now, it's been a while ago, a couple months ago, I kept seeing steam stacks. Plant has been mentioned a few times, but he called it a factory, which makes sense for a little boy, right? Also, they incinerate trash there, so if he would have not been found, he would have been incinerated if they had not gotten to him. It's also by NASA, so that's the moon and the stars. So those were his things. Also, Mill, he lived at Mill Creek Apartments, so the Mill is very, very strong. It connects all over the place. So there's a huge interconnection to these cases. They happen around the same time. As you can see, there's, it's just kind of crazy how that happens, right? It kind of still blows me away. So back to the reference of Ted and Nancy. By bringing into the reference of him stating that AJ drove like Bundy did, and did in fact go to the mountains between them in the canyon. Canyon did come up in Malia, and actually did spring too, if you go back and watch. There's also Gavanna Malibu up the way, kind of like a beachy place here in California, is what you call Malibu, and the G also. Lucy was brought up in the very beginning of the second reading. There is a very, very old skeleton found on Bundy's birthday, November 24th, 1974. Really trippy, huh? So it's kind of weird, but they were trying to point to Bundy and the similarities there. So when I had seen Logan before, because we did go there on the map a few times, I kept being reminded of Lizzie for some reason. Maybe I should have kept following that. Maybe they were trying to tell me something. But I was thinking at the same time, you know, they found her, and then maybe the whole between the mountains thing was Bundy. Like, because I was being pulled in so many different directions. But I keep telling myself, like, I should have known better. So they're just saying that the similarities of where they put the bodies and how they drove. So I said to, oh, also for Nancy, the ruby ring. Okay, so Ted did have a body that he said he put at Ruby Rock in Coral Canyon. Nancy had a ruby ring. Well, I said to my group, isn't ruby for July, right? Because sometimes, like I say, there's symbolic meanings here. And, well, she was found July 5th. So now that makes sense now. 8 could partly be for 89. There's also a Millville Peak Wildlife Management Area. There's also Hydro Park, the high again in reference to R. It's actually called Ray Huggy Hydro. The area that she found does look cliffy. Actually, Logan Peak is right above it, so that would be a cliff overlooking her. Mill Hollow, she was literally right by it. It's possible the reason why she showed me empty wallet was symbolic. It may actually be a stretch, but it made me feel, because it was empty and it had no money when she showed it to me. So money is known as cash. This was Cache County. I'm horrible at puzzles. I don't know if I would have put that together. They do have houses around there. Cherry Peak is right on the other side. It points just to that area that we would have been in the right area had we have seen it. It's just further up. It is a peak. If you don't scroll in on the map, you don't see it. So it was just a way to get us to look in that area. I did not see Cherry Peak before. Again, when we would have had my wheel spinning. And maybe I would have looked harder in the area. This area was described right, though. I mean, it is between the mountains. There is a river there. Like I said, reservoir came in before. It is woodsy. It is right by mill. We just honestly didn't think he would drive that far. But then there's a reference to Bundy and how he put girls in the mountains. So I guess they were trying to tell us all along. And now we're smacking our heads against the wall because now it's like, duh, and it makes complete sense. But when we were doing it, when we were trying to figure it out, we were just wondering, like, what the heck? Maybe because Utah Bundy was so active, you know? So the area is all cliffy and full of peaks. So I wish I would have kept looking. I kept thinking, this isn't over. Why, you know, why would I keep seeing the two mountains so dang clear? I also said she was mentioning multiple locations, which she was. I did have, again, that pool because of Lizzie and being reminded of it. It just didn't click. They had all the stuff with the burning tissue, which did match the reading, so it was kind of confusing reading, so I was like, okay, it's, you know, done. Everything was right there, though. She did tell us exactly what to do, where to go, everything. It's putting it together, puzzle pieces, kind of tough sometimes. So I just wish she would have said Logan. It would have made my life so much easier. I really did not realize that U of U was in Logan. I was looking all over that map. I was being pulled in multiple directions. So, but I did, like, definitely keep going pull between mountains, and so, you know, now I'm thinking about it, and I'm like, well, she was pointing to the university, now I realize the university's in Logan, but see, I was being pulled in all different directions. Like I said, Utah, you guys got some crazy stuff out there. Now, in an auto write, Utah was mentioned, so there was going to be something big going on there. Also, Bundy was mentioned at the beginning, I believe it was auto rate 3, either 2 or 3, I think 3, very beginning talking about going up the mountains and a reddish, she had freckles across her nose and reddish hair. Well, when you zoom in on Nancy Beard, that's exactly how she looks. We got another picture, she has the freckles across and she has the reddish hair, so I'm thinking that it's possibly It was stating that that was an unnamed victim. He denied he ever did anything with her, but the way that it's coming across, I think I'd really have to do reading, but I'm thinking I'm not so sure about that because I do plan on doing a Ted Bundy series. It's going to take some time because what I want to do is look at the unnamed victims and see if we can figure out where they are, see who they are. He did kind of have a type, so there are certain people that I'm drawn to. I do think Nancy is one of them. It seems to come across that way. But I was really being pulled in all different directions here because that boy really did pull me hard to crematory. It means cliff, too. But he was found in Box Elder County off of that road. And he was pulling me there because I really could not leave that name. And I notice when I'm being pulled to names sometimes, not necessarily that area, but that name will have matched somewhere. I feel really bad for Mackenzie and the poor little Noah. It's really sad, both situations. It's just kind of crazy how they interconnected. But, you know, all this shaming going on about her is really not okay. She's still someone's daughter. She's still human. And my sincerest condolences do go out to the family and friends of her and the family and friends of little Noah and everybody else that came through in this reading. I'm glad that, you know, they can have services now. I feel bad I wasn't such a great listener in this one or follower. Sometimes it's really hard putting it together. And as you see, I've gotten multiple cases here. Utah, you guys got something going on out there. I try not to do that, but like I said, I was being pulled in all those different directions. I'm still learning what my pulls feel like. My clairsentience is not very strong. I do admit that. I always say the maps just make my head go crazy and I don't ever feel much, you know. But I'm starting to feel pulls and they're starting to make sense. They mean something. So it's learning to pay attention to how I'm feeling. And if I would have paid more attention, you know, maybe. So it just felt like it was so far. But each and every reading is learning a lesson. Kind of trying to figure all this interconnecting isn't really easy. So one thing I also want to mention is that Peaches came out in Delphi reading. And as you know, Delphi, I've gotten multiple cases in that. I'm thinking about putting out 10 on YouTube because it's only on my page and only on the podcast. But I've noticed my podcast is missing. So I am going to try to get my podcast re-going, by the way. And we're hoping to get that up and running soon. Anyways, so Peaches came out in Delphi. Also, I got Peaches in this. There was a Peaches that was found, said to be a victim of the Long Island serial killer, the Long Island Ripper, whatever you want to call him. They had three people, all with the last name B, that they said, you know, had something to do with it. I'm not so sure that they found her killer. If you look at the case, their blue is mentioned there. There's a couple of other things that are mentioned that match this reading. So that was kind of interesting as well. And then now, I did get, like I said, I got the reference to the Indian doctor, leaving that alone. It did connect to Mackenzie. There's other stuff that came through. I'm not going to validate that we found out. We're just going to leave it alone. So the other doctor that I did see was, if you remember kind of how, if you've ever seen Cardinal on Hulu, that's what it reminded me of, you know. The dark hair, the beard, the mustache, and he had a mask on his over his face, and he was the one that was cutting off body parts. So that might be an interconnect that may not have happened yet, but it's kind of weird that that's what happened to Peaches, and that I'm seeing this, and maybe it's the fact that I'm being shown a Long Island serial killer in a way. Maybe he was a doctor, thought he was a doctor, maybe he had some kind of training there. I'm not so sure, but that's who I keep seeing. It's very, very strong. So, if you guys can, you can Google what he looks like, and that's what I'm kind of seeing. And so that's the interconnect here with Mackenzie's leg, you know, being severed, body parts being taken off. So, I think there's going to be an interconnect somewhere. If there's not, if, you know, if it's not just interconnecting there, it could have also just said, hey, you know, this happened to them, this is what happened to Mackenzie kind of thing. So, anyways, I hope you guys can understand what I'm saying. This was the second time doing this video. Again, I don't honestly don't know what happened, but I apologize for the technical difficulties. I want to thank you for liking and subscribing. Don't forget to join the Psychic Sleuth podcast. Don't forget to answer the questions. I'm not going to add you if you don't answer them. If you want to contact me regarding a case, I'm so far behind doing what I can, but regarding a case, a private reading, validation, anything like that, you can contact me at thepsychicsleuth@gmail.com or gentleheartreadings@hotmail.com. Again, thank you for your support. Appreciate you listening. I'll talk to you later.